Hi everyone, welcome you all for my new lecture on dimensional analysis. Hope you watched my previous lectures on dimensional analysis, homogeneity of a dimensional equation and dimensions expressed in MLT systems. Now it is time to know how to do dimensional analysis. This video will give you an idea on how to do dimensional analysis by Rayleigh method. You know, in nature, every physical phenomenon depends on various parameters. Those parameters are called as variables of a particular problem. If variables of a particular problem are known, then the relation among those can be formed by two methods. One is Rayleigh method. First one is Rayleigh method. Second one is Buckingham Pi theorem. As I mentioned earlier, in this video, we will discuss about the Rayleigh method only. I already told you the physical phenomenon will depend on various parameters. That parameters are called as variables of a particular problem. If the number of variables are 3 or 4 only, then you can use Rayleigh method to form the dependent variable from the known independent variables. In case if your problem has more than 4 unknown variables, then it is very critical or it is really tough to find out dependent variable by using this Rayleigh method. In that case, you have to go for Buckingham Pi theorem. Let me explain the Rayleigh method. The first step in Rayleigh method is to form a mathematical equation. Now consider a variable x. Consider a variable x. This variable x depends on various parameters, that is various variables x1, x2, x3 and so on. In this case, we will take only 3 or 4 variables. So it is expressed like x1, x2, x3. Now this variable x is a function of x1, x2, x3. Then according to the Rayleigh method, the mathematical equation can be formed as like x equal to k into x1 power a, x2 power b, x3 power c, where k is a constant and a comma b comma c are known as arbitrary constant. Then as usual, this equation must be solved to form a dependent variable. Now let me take a problem and explain you the Rayleigh method very clearly. Now consider a pump. The power required for that pump depends on various parameters. That is, I am taking for an example, I am taking the parameters, that is the variables are head value H, second one discharge value Q, third one specific weight of the liquid W, fourth one, since it is the first problem, I restrict myself to 3 unknown plus 1 unknown parameters. That is 3 plus 1, 4 unknown variables. That is 4 independent variables. So the first step is to write the mathematical equation. So power equal to k into h power a, q power b and w power c. That is specific weight power c. So where k is a non-dimensional number. Then, in the second step, you have to express these variables in terms of MLT unit system. So, in case if you don't know the MLT unit system, watch my lecture on dimensions in the series of dimensional analysis. For power, the MLT unit system is M L T power minus 3, that is actually it is M L power 2 T power minus 3, which is equal to K into, the head is expressed in meters of water, so it can be expressed as L to the power A. The unit of H is meter cube per, sorry, unit of Q is meter cube per second. So meter can be expressed in L, that is L power 3 divided by time, so T power minus 1. Then it can be written as L power 3 T power minus 1 to the whole power arbitrary constant B. Then the MLT system for specific weight is M L power minus 2 T power minus 2 to the whole power C. So the next step, from the next step the problem becomes very easy. So in the next step you consider the power of M, that is the power of M. In the right hand side the power of M is 1, which is equal to, in the left hand side the power of M is 1. In the right hand side the power of M is, here no, there is no M. Here also there is no M, here there is M power 1, so to the power C, so it is 1C. If you consider the power only, it will come 1C, so C equal to 1. Right, now consider the power of L. In the left hand side, the power of L is 2, in the right hand side, the power of L is, here A plus the power of L is 3 into B. So 3B plus the power of L is minus 2 and minus 2 into C. So minus 2C. Okay, this is the second equation we got. And the third equation should be power of T. In the right hand side, the power of T is minus 3. Which is equal to, in the left hand side, in the power of A there is no power of A, there is no T here, and here T power minus 1, so it is minus B, minus 1B written as minus B. Here it is minus 2C, so minus 2C, directly I am writing minus 2C. Now I can written as this equation as 1, this equation as 2, and this equation as 3. Now my first step, I find out the value for C. So I have to find out the, I have to substitute the value of C in other two equations, that is in equation 2 and 3. So the equation 2 becomes, once I substitute the value of C, that is substitute the C value as 1, the equation 2 becomes 2 equal to A plus 3B minus 2C. Already it is minus 2C, so substitute the value C as 1, so it will become minus 2. So the overall equation becomes, if it comes here, it is 4 equal to A plus 3B, and the third equation will become minus 3 equal to minus B minus of 2 into C. C value is 1, so I am writing as minus 2. So now the value of B becomes 1. Now substitute the B value here, you will get 4 equal to A plus 3. So A equal to 4 minus 3, 1. So I got the A value as 1, B value as 1 and C value as 1. Now substitute A comma B comma C value in equation 1. So if you substitute equation ABC value in equation 1, you will get P equal to K into H power 1, Q power 1, W power 1. So P can be written as K into HQW. This is the answer we find out. In this problem, there are only 4 independent variables. So the problem is very easy. So now I will discuss if in case you have 5 or 6 independent variables, then how to use this Rayleigh method. So I am taking a problem on drag force. So I am considering that my drag force F is depends on the values of diameter of the object, that is diameter of the object D, and velocity of the object V, and the density of the fluid in which object is flowing or flying. So density, and the fourth one, viscosity of the fluid. Now there are 5 independent variables. Now let us discuss how to solve this problem. So as like in the last problem, the first step is to form the mathematical equation. So mathematical equation is F equal to K into D power A, P power B, rho power C and the mu power D. Right? The second step is you have to write this equation in the form of MLT unit system. So the drag force, that is the force, the MLT system for a force is M L power minus 2, which is equal to K into, diameter is a length, so L power A. Again velocity can be written as LT power minus 1 whole power B, and the density can be written as M L minus 3 to the power C, and the viscosity can be written as M power L power minus 1 T power minus 1 to the power D. Now the next step, I have to write the first one, power of M. Second step, power of L. Third step, power of T. Now the Rayleigh method is, I told you the Rayleigh method is difficult to handle more than 4 independent variables. Why means you will have 3 equations here, and if you have 4 unknowns, if you have 4 independent variables, then there will be 3 arbitrary constant A, B, C. Then to find the arbitrary constants A, B, C, that is 3 arbitrary constant with the help of 3 equations, it is very easy. But if you have 5 independent variables, then you will have 4 arbitrary constant A, B, C, D. So to find the A, B, C, D, that is 4 values from the 3 equations, it will require some mathematical applications, which we are going to discuss. From the last equation, you know that the power of M in the left hand side, it is equal to 1. In the right hand side, power of M is C plus D. Okay. Similarly, the power of L is in the left hand side, it is 1. In the right hand side, it is A plus B minus 3C minus D. The power of T is in the right hand side it is minus 2, in the left hand side it is minus B minus D. So this equation is 1, this equation is 2, this equation is 3. Now to find these 4 values, you have to use these 3 equations. So you have to mention all other three arbitrary constant in terms of the fourth constant. That fourth constant is decided by the important or dominant variable. So in the problem of drag force, I consider that the dominant variable is mu. So the corresponding arbitrary constant of mu is d. So I have to express all other equations in terms of d. That is, I have to express a, b, c in terms of d. Right, consider the first equation. So c can be expressed in terms of d. So c equal to 1 minus d. And now consider the third equation. It has b and d. So the equation b can be written in terms of d. So b equal to 2 minus d. Now consider the equation number 2. I have to express a in terms of d. Now consider the equation number 2. So a equal to 1 minus b plus 3c plus d. I am keeping the a this side and all other things goes to this side. A equal to 1 minus b plus 3c plus d. So now I am going to substitute this b value and c value here. So it will come 1 minus 2 minus d plus 3 minus 3d plus d. If you solve this equation, you will get the value of a. The value of a becomes 2 minus d. Now I have the three equations, that is b, another one is c, last one is a. Now substitute the values of a, b, c in equation number 1. That is in this equation. So now substitute values of a, b, c in equation number 1. You will get f equal to k into d power, the value of a is 2 minus d, and v power, the value of b is 2 minus d, and density power, the value of c is 1 minus d into mu. So this equation can be written as k into, I am splitting the power, d squared d power minus d v squared v power minus d rho power 1 into rho power minus d mu. So I am taking out d squared v squared rho mu. So here mu power, here it is mu power d. So here it is mu power d. So here also it is mu power d. So I am taking out d squared v squared rho. So it is mu power d into d power minus d into v power minus d into rho power minus d. So now this equation can be rewritten as k d squared v squared rho into mu divided by dv rho to the whole power d. So because of minus, I kept it in the denominator. So now this equation can be written as, to remove the arbitrary constant, we have to put this k into d squared v squared rho function of mu divided by dv That's all. In the next lecture, we will discuss about Buckingham Pi theorem. Thank you.